welcome back to Let's Interactively Play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm Amethyst and Atari, and this is, well, a Let's Play where you get to vote at the end of the video what should be done going forward starting the next video. And you stand once more. Now we are close to this thing this time, but the way it's like, I don't know. It's the Dragon of Time. Which makes me think that maybe it can attack you at any time, because when we're in this past, well, scroll out, we're in this past area where everything is verdant and lush, as opposed to, like, a barren wasteland. The barren wasteland is the present, and the desert area is the past. So I'm not sure if the dragon is in this time or not, or if he can be in any time. So, rather than the choices last video were to either explore inland, sorry my voice is a little scratchy, or to ring the bell, yeah, it was unanimous to ring the bell, and by doing that we will be able to go back to the mainland here, and hopefully get, well, we could definitely get to this tower here, but I'm hoping is we can teleport from this tower to this tower, because I'm unable to climb these cliffs. So that's what we're going to try to do. Ring my bell. You ring the shoreline bell. After a few minutes, a boat slides out of the mist of the lake towards you. The ferryman hops down into the shallows. I seem to be seeing a lot of you, he remarks. Get on board the boat. You clamber into the boat, and the ferryman pushes you away from shore. I think this is the first time we've taken one of these boats. Yeah, we have. Look at that. Our avatar becomes a boat. Of course. We went back into the past again. So the boat no longer exists. The boat slides away from the shore. But somewhere along the way you pass out of the light from the distant beacon. Or we went, okay. Okay, so then we went to the present. We went from the past back into the present. Because these people are not here in the present. They're all have died. Either horribly or by natural causes. So you pass out of the light from the distant beacon, and the ferryman's grumbling talk seems to waver and disappear, as does the boat itself. What would crying out accomplish? And jump, what, into the water? Cling on? Can I go back to the past with him? Probably not. You make a grab for the edge of the boat, but your hand goes straight through the gunwale and into the water. A moment later, you are splashing into the cold waters of the lake. Away from the shore, there is no choice but to start swimming. You pause for a moment, holding up your head and catching your breath. All right. Yeah, this is the area, right? So this is... I really want to avoid the serpent for the time being, anyway. We don't have any clues how to defeat this thing. Like every other serpent, except this one, we have clues for. Water, air, time, he's on an island, right? We know that already. Earth serpents... Fire serpents, moon serpents. We don't know the weakness of this. If so, if I could find out that weakness, that would be a good idea, rather than just trying to defeat it on my own. So we're going to keep going because, well, our destination is still here, to get back to this tower. So I'm going to... try to swim all the way back, I guess. Not going near the serpent, trying to get away and around, if possible. Swimming like this is hard work. The sun is hot now. Okay, we lost another point of stamina. We've been here near the statues. I'm not sure if I can... I don't think I could get up here. I mean, there might be a way, but... we're not ready to advance past this yet. Another point. You swim onwards across the surface of the lake. It is hard going. The afternoon is starting to draw on. Your rest, wiping your eyes. See, because this ultimately leads... Oh, I guess up here. Oh, no? Wait. I guess it leads, yeah, up here. Following the Caravan River and more or less, well, not really near it, but... Oh, look, when you put it like that, it looks like a serpent. See it? Huh. Yeah, but this leads off, and I'm guessing that this chapter ends there into chapter 4, which is the last one where you're coming across the grand... not the grand wizard. Oh, you have a lot of choices. I want to head back to this island. I believe you, go ashore here, so... Yeah, I'm not ready to end the chapter just yet. Down to 10 stamina. You keep a steady rhythm as you make your way through the water. The wind picks up as the evening draws on. Soon it will be dark. Alright, this is the one with the Sightmaster. Which is, might not be a pleasant place to be. And his eyes... Flame shoots out of his eyes, and he opened his eyes and burned himself. So let's go here where the hag is and... get some rest, and then we'll head back. Swimming like this is very tiring. The sun has all but gone. You stop briefly, treading water and catching your breath. Near the island. Alright, you swim on through the water. It is tiring work. Darkness closes in. You should try to find a suitable spot to sleep, especially after so long swimming with an empty belly. I have a ration. You have swum within reach of a small island. You will need to go ashore. Yes, I want to go ashore. You wade through the shallows of the shore. The moon oozes across the sky like a drop of quicksilver. The dark is treacherous. You will have to rest here. Laying your pack on the shore of the lake, you try to stretch out. Despite the shivering cold of your still wet clothing, you have eaten nothing today. Eat something. Here we go. Out of rations once again. Well, I'll go shopping at that village again. That'd be good. I have plenty of gold still. You eat the smoked fish and feel much better for it. Then you stretch out and rest. What is left of the night is restless with visions. The lynch bug queen lies in front of you, sharpening her thighs against each other as she decides which part to eat first. Lovely. The Sightmaster Sergeant, bleeding thickly from the mouth, is explaining combat drills to you. He demonstrates each blow by hitting himself hard with his staff. Yep, yep. Do it all, you feel the heat of Anilan burning, should your quest fail. Yeah, because what he was doing... He decided to kill himself rather than destroy the whole region, which is pretty nice of him. An island, day 24. During the past day, you ran out of provisions and found no new clues. Well, I hope to get more provisions. The sun rises above the waters of the lake. The center of the island is covered by dead forest, and near the shoreline is a bell for the ferry. Can I rest more? Rest and recover? You seat yourself by the lake shore to meditate and recover your strength. A few clouds race across the sky. Nice. 16, nice. You make ready to move on again, feeling much better. So almost at full, which is good. There's something at the... I threw a coin. You have another look in your pack for a suitable missile. Right, the rope broke. The pebbles we can use as exploding pebbles. I don't want to throw that. Throw the whistle. Throw the pipe. Throw a coin. You flick a gold piece at the bell. The bell rings, but your missile is lost in the water. After a few minutes, a boat slides out of the mist of the lake towards you. The ferryman hops down into the shallows. You again, he smiles. Climb aboard. Let's see if it works this time. Get on board the boat. You clamber into the boat, and the ferryman pushes you away from shore. The ferryman pulls the boat onwards across the water. The day is likely to be clear and will be hot once more. The boat drifts. The ferryman stands at the prow, scanning the water. You going to the ancient road? He asks. All the way to High Zaman? The ancient road? Used to be a thriving settlement, this. One of the most powerful cities in the world. Before the curse, of course. I just want to get some more information from him, if he might have anything. The curse? You've walked the wilds, I'd say. You've seen it. Nothing stays real for long around here. Things don't happen in the right order. Unstuck the whole place. Cool. Unstuck in time. Glancing down at the oars still resting in the boat, and then at you, he shrugs his wide, heavy shoulders. Plenty of places to see on Lake Oklala, he muses, and few below. And a few below. He hefts his pole and stares away into the distance. Okay. Heading back. Happens again. The ferryman pushes a small coracle? I don't know. I'm familiar with that word. Forwards through the lake. You are lulled into watching the water, and suddenly the light changes and water is all around you. The boat and ferryman have gone. Jump. You jump clear as the boat vanishes. With a splash, you land in the water below. Out in the middle of the water, there is no alternative but to start swimming. You pause for a moment, lifting your face from the water. And then we unpause. Let's go here. I lost stamina again. You try to maintain a regular stroke as you swim. The mid-afternoon heat floods the valley. You swim within reach of the north shore. Oh. Oh. I didn't see that. I'm like, what? I can't go to shore. Another stamina. You haul yourself onto land. Mid-afternoon haze makes the air damp. The shore teems with activity. Heat beats down from the empty sky. Now, I think the food is here. Not sure. You return to the stalls to browse further. Let's buy some fish. Oh, isn't that... The fish is not cooked, I believe. We lose our uncooked food? Raw meat. Oh, two raw fish. See? The fish are raw, so... I have all this food. Kind of like the water. Water, water everywhere, and not a drop to drink. So let's... leave. I don't need any more raw fish. How about some fruit? You can buy that. Eat that raw. I'll buy some apples, you tell the hawker. He nods. How many? Buy one? I forget how much they are. They're two each. That's two gold to you, the man replies, accepting your coins. You put the fruit into your pack. All right. You move away from the stalls. The sun is beginning to lower, and the air begins to cool. I do want to buy some more stuff. I think I have to head here and then head back, so... I don't remember what's here. Oh, you spend the afternoon on the shore, watching the sun go down across the mountains to the west, then gather your cloak as the night... cold night sets in. The stallholders and fishermen pack away, deporting the shoreline in all directions and disappearing from view as they leave the light from the distant beacon. I'm guessing it's not all directions. I don't think they're heading south. Creatures snuffle through the discarded fish heads near their stalls. Find somewhere to rest. Time to rest. Sleeping in a stall worked last time. I guess I'll eat something. I'll buy four apples, I think. Once again, you break into a market stall and lie down under the shelter of its canopied roof. Removing your pack on the shore of the lake, you try to rest to spare the shivering cold of your still wet clothing. You have not yet eaten today. Eat something. Pulling the apple from your bag, you eat your first meal of the day. Then you close your eyes and let your tiredness overtake you. You feel quite safe here, and you do not dream. Which is funny, because the only time you're given an opportunity... Oh, actually, you can go into your inventory at any point and eat something. I'm not sure, but I think during the first chapter or two, you couldn't just eat something whenever you wanted. I could be wrong, or maybe I just didn't realize that mechanic at the time. Alright, so, we do not dream. In the past day, you lost some gold. Minus three. I found no new clues. Yes, one to the bell, and two for the one apple. The sun rises, bringing with it clatter... or chatter and excitement, as well as stall holders and fishermen begin to gather at the shoreline. The sky is blue and pink. I'm heading back here to this stall. Fruit. I'll buy 4 of them. That's 8 gold to you. You put the fruit in your pack. Don't need any more raw fish. I can't cook the stuff I have. I wonder when and where we'll have an opportunity to cook any of that stuff. 2 raw fish and another raw carcass of something or other. You move away from the stalls. The sun has not yet crested the last peaks in the east. Okay, I don't seem to be able to head to this stall. Maybe that's only to sleep. Maybe you can't buy anything there. Alright, let's head back towards the tower. You turn away from the lakeshore and follow the paved road back along the riverbank. Alright, here's where we go. We start moving through time again, I think. Yeah. You leave the shore for an old road across the plains. A few clouds furl and unfurl in the sky. You walk forwards. The road curves gently as you follow it. As the morning moves on, the wind begins to rise. The road is busy as before. You stride on. And now we're in the past. Or no, we're in the present. That was the past. I get a little confused. You follow the old road. The road seems to break and shatter as you walk. It is hot now. Time to move onwards. Agreed. The winds whistle through the broken buildings of the city. The sun has reached its highest point now. Out of the shade, the air is baking hot. To the tower! You make your way back toward the tower. You stand at the bottom of the tower, listening to the silence outside. You could return up the tower or back out into the street. Up. The metal cylinder rests on its rack. Touch the blue crystal. You touch the blue crystal and are quickly, dizzyingly high. Okay, can we... No! It's not been discovered yet. I can't go there. Seriously? You can only go to the ones you've already discovered. Which makes sense, but... How the hell do I get up there, then? I wonder if the whistle would bring me there. Well, what I think I'm going to do, since it's right around here, I'm going to turn this away, and I'm going to face this dragon. You fall downwards. You find yourself on top of a tower that looks out over a ruined city. The telescope-like cylinder also sits on its setting. Suggest the beam. Just turn it anywhere away. What if I turn it... Well, that's facing the town. Just anywhere away. That's fine. You adjust the contraption around the tower, passing the glow across the land. I sure do. You would turn down the tower steps. So you can see that serpent. You call them dragons. You head off into the ruins once more. The evening is drawing in. It will be night soon. The streets are silent as the grave now. Wasn't there a dragon here? A serpent, I mean? Oh, I have a beam facing that way. I want to turn that beam away as well then. Okay. Up, up, up. Alright. Sweet. Great sound effects. Well, it's just a beam here. Turn it away from that. We step back to regard its effects. Oh wait, no, I don't want to climb down. But I have to climb down and go back up. It's like partially illuminated by what? Really wonder how we can get there. Am I, like, not remembering correctly? Could have sworn there were two dragons we could see in the lake. Can we rest? Can we rest at the tower and eat? Sleep. I don't think I need to eat unless I'm lacking stamina. You gained some revisions plus 4 and lost significant goal minus 8 and found no new clues. Okay. I didn't lose stamina by doing that. Well, let's try it now. We're in the present. You leave the city by the old road. The air moves a little, still icy, but fresh. Time to move onwards. It's a lot of traveling. Sure I've read all that before. The sun continues to climb the steep sky. You follow the road downhill to the lakeshore, looking out across the vast expanse of still water which stretches to the horizon. Your resolve grows. How can you cross? There are no signs of either people or boats. The far shore is nothing but a blur against the sky. Maybe in the current timeline we can climb the island. I mean, if that was affected by the beam, maybe it's crumbled to the effect that we can climb up and get to that tower. That would be sweet. What would walking along the shoreline be? I guess it gives us more opportunities to move. Blow the whistle? The sound of the whistle scuds across the open water. A few minutes later, the undergrowth nearby begins to rustle. Cast a spell. Guessing sense danger. Yeah. You cast a spell and a calm voice enters your mind. The voice warns you that there is tremendous danger close at hand, that you must be every moment on your guard. Then the spell fades. Just as the leaves of the bushes part. The man emerges from the bush, a scruffy, unwashed individual, somewhat overweight, but with the shoulders of an ox. That he no doubt needs to pole across the water each day, or all day. He scratches his chest thoroughly, thoughtfully. Okay, for a moment I thought we were facing a minotaur. But no, he has the shoulders of an ox. He's not part ox. So he responded to the whistle, but there is tremendous danger close at hand. Well, probably one of the serpents. Greetings, I guess. And greetings unto you, fair traveler, he replies, scratching his nose as he speaks. Now, where to? Why would we just sit there and wait? I wish to cross the lake. Of course she wants to cross the lake, he laughs. Everyone wants to cross the lake. Everyone that's around these parts, anyway. But I still ask, where to? It's my little jest. He wipes a little tear from his eye. Right on, then. Wherever you want on the lake. 4 gold pieces. Yeah. Gonna pay him. You pay him the money. He disappears into the undergrowth once more and reappears a few moments later, dragging a heavy boat behind him. Give me a hand, idiot, he barks. I'll help him, sure. Together you pull the boat into the water. It bobs and rocks in the shallows, but seems seaworthy enough. You get in. Then he pushes you out into the water and hops aboard himself. All right. Away from the shore. I'm guessing it's not the same ferryman. The ferryman pulls the boat on across the water. Mid-afternoon heat makes the air sticky. It seems you have reached a part of the lake that is too deep for the pole. The ferryman points sharply at you and snaps, "Take the oars, fool, and start rowing." Demand my money back? Well, I do want to get to my destination. Let me row, I guess. You shrug and take the oars. I thought he might have been taking the other oar. He's just sitting there doing nothing. Okay. The water is thick and heavy, and every stroke is tiring work. The ferryman is silent, watching it as you struggle forwards through the water. All right, well, I want to head there, which I think you can go around here, so I'm going to head this way. I guess I'm still going to lose stamina, right, from rowing. You continue sculling the boat while the ferryman steers with the pole. The afternoon is drawing on. From his place at the prow, the ferryman watches you thoughtfully. You been to Tin Pang, he asks. You from there? Why do you ask? You reply, suspecting his question conceals more below its surface. Exactly. Strange place, Tin Pang, the ferryman replies. Was destroyed a long time ago, turned into a ruin, completely abandoned, long, long time ago. But people still come down the road, time and again, wanting ferrying from there. It's most of my trade. Where did they go, these people? You ask. Now that's a good question, and the strange thing is, all different places. Some are headed for the Horns, trying to get across them, since the bridge is gone. Others want the Zaman Road, but are meaning to turn south to the sea. Others think the fortress will harbor them. The fortress? The Fortress of Sorcerers. That's what Manpang was called before it became Mangpang. Before the Archmage really came into his own. The ferryman tests the water with his pole, but it is still too deep. Do any visit the islands? The islands? He replies, surprised. Now why would they do that? All these islands are empty. If they're empty, why do they have bells? He laughs gently. Now that's a good question, and I don't know the answer. I'm last in a long line of ferrymen across this lake, and I couldn't tell you how old those bells are. Amazing that they still ring. The ferryman chuckles. Well, the ferryman replies with a twinkle in his eye, I can see you'll never be setting foot in Tin Pang again anyhow. Okay. Is that supposed to sound ominous? You row onwards. Lost another stamina point. Under the ferryman's guidance, slowly the sun begins to lower in the sky. You travel for a moment in silence, just pulling on the oars. Yeah, all the above. Tell me about the ancient road. The Acolyte Way, he replies. Time was, plenty of folks were crossing these waters on their way to High Zaman and the fortress, going to study, studying the stars. Not so much anymore. His expression is distant and glazed over. What can you tell me of the Seven Serpents? There is no reply. He does not seem to have heard you. His face is static and unmoving. What have you seen? You demand, twisting in your seat. Oh, God. The ferryman's mouth moves open. A curious hissing sound emerges. Help him? He's one of the serpents. You reach out to... Oh, no. You reach out to catch him as his body slumps sideways and a plume of thick smoke emerges from between his teeth. His body remains in place for a moment, then collapses like a limp sack, slithering into the bottom of the boat. Look at him. What? You bend down towards the ferryman. Nothing remains but for a pile of clothing. The swirling creature... What? The swirling creature overhead? I guess the swirling creature overhead is the gas? Becomes agitated. The swirling creature over... I guess it's the thick smoke. Because this is the first mention of a creature. The swirling creature overhead becomes agitated and starts to flicker and waft in your face. Its gas is choking and noxious. There's a choking smell filling your nostrils. Searches clothing. Ignoring the smell of the creature in your nose, you rifle through the pile of tattered clothing, finding nothing but a shriveled piece of scaly flesh. A fish skin? Leave that, the creature declares, or I will kill you. Take it? You pick up the scaled strip. Not from a fish, it is the skin of a snake. Leave it, the creature screams. The choking smell is gathering around you more strongly now. Gonna leave it here, guys. What do you think I should do? Should I acquiesce to the creature's demands and leave the snake skin? Should I tear the skin apart? Sounds like a reasonable idea. Or should I ask this creature, what is it? Leave your comments below. Yeah, one of the three. Let me know what you think I should do going forward, beginning in the next video. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks for voting and enduring. Grow strong. See you next week.